Welcome everyone to another episode of So Bad It's Good. We haven't done one of these in quite a while, but since Diwali is coming up, we thought we would talk about a very bombastic movie. It is very bombastic in a true sense, like from the script to the box office collections, everywhere. Like, this movie truly wreaked havoc everywhere, but today we're going to be talking about Thugs of Hindostan. I'm not quite sure what the pronunciation is. I kept asking Jay, like, is it Hindostan or Hindustan? But we're going to leave it. We're just going to call it Thugs. That's the sound effects for today's episode. We can't use the actual music because Yashraj films just, you know, they don't like people using its music. let's get to this movie now. This movie, it was something, wasn't it? Like, when it released, it was released in 2018. It was released in Diwali. There was a lot of promotion, like, going into this film. Mm-hmm. Like, this was this big budget, you know, is this the Indian Pirates of the Caribbean movie? And
we wish, man.
It was definitely, it was definitely there. Maybe, you know, like, you could see the inspiration, but it stopped there, like, right there. Like, it didn't go more than that. It didn't really deliver to the quality of it. And to be honest, Pirates of the Caribbean, even though it's an amazing, like, franchise, like, even even movies in that series, there are a few duds in those. And the fact that this movie didn't really come close to even those duds, I think it speaks volumes of what this film is. But Wikipedia says that it's an Indian Hindi language action adventure film written and directed by yours truly, Vijay Krishnacharya. And dude, I am actually very happy with this, that we decided to do this today. You know why?
Why?
The main reason is that this completes our trilogy of the father character being killed off in the first five minutes of the movie.
You know, like, while watching the movie, I realized the same thing, like, in Saho, in, what was it, Doom 3,
Jack Chirp died again.
Then, yeah, like, Ronnie.
See, I was so pissed that... Why didn't they bring Jack Sherman back for this?
That, like, would have been perfect.
Could have brought him back, like, ruining our trilogy. Yeah.
Good. I just realized that Jackie Shroff has died in the first 5 minutes of Bharat as well. Salman Khan starring Bharat.
Yeah.
Like, oh man, damn.
Someone should give Jack Sherman a good, sizable role, full length role, where, you know, he gets to be in the start till the end.
Yeah.
Without anything happening to him. Like, it's like he is like endangered species, you know, when he does a character, like, anytime.
Dude, like, from now onwards, whenever I will see Jackie Shroff, now, I'm saying, I'm gonna, like, bet on it, like, it's happening, it's going to happen, there comes the car, it's about to happen, yeah.
No, but this film was supposed to be this, you know, the story about this small time thug, you know, and how he's trying to infiltrate this enemy.
Yeah.
And straight away, this film, it has all the Vijay Krishnacharya traits. It has a very decent first 10-15 minutes where everything starts off pretty well. Like, you know, you have the action set piece coming.
The
emotions of the story, same like what he did with Doom 3. You know, you have this flashback. And even in Doom 3, that was done pretty decently. Like, you know, setting up the emotions, setting up the stage for the confrontation. The only addition is that in this, you have the British guy speaking Hindi also. Like, Jay will come to that, but I'll just go ahead. Like, you know, and that first scene is actually the first, like, the first 5 to 10 minutes where, you know, the attack is happening and everything. It's done pretty decently. Like, you know, there are a few things that are a little bit far-fetched, but like, you know, how he attacks it so simply, like, how does a king not see this through and stuff like that. But I'm like, I'm willing to put that all aside because considering how bad the movie gets.
And it's a Vijay Krishnacharya movie,
Yeah. And I must say, you know, and then the host, like, there's a scene where, you know, the entire, like, treasure, the castle that her daughter, the king's daughter builds in the sand, it goes away.
Yeah.
Like, it vibes away. And I was like, that was actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Like, you know, that visual metaphor is trying to, like, show that the entire house is gone.
True.
That was actually good. But then the movie, you know, you actually think that, okay, when it gets to the main character and, you know, that's when the fun starts. No. Not in this film. This film is the reverse. I'm getting ahead of myself. I'll get to Jay, but I just want to make one small point. Like, in Vijay Krishna Acharya movies, again, you see the same trait happening. You have a person going undercover as usual. Like, in Doom 1, he was a writer. In that, you had Uday Chopra going undercover. Doom 2, you had Aishwarya Rai going undercover. He was a writer there. In Doom 3, Abhishek Bachchan itself went undercover. And in this, you have Amar Khan getting undercover again. Like, I feel like undercover is his like main thing.
Yeah.
And honestly, I think that he is maybe a raw agent.
Yeah.
Oh. Vijay Krishna Acharya. And he's trying to like give his message.
That's why it makes him that he suck at making movies. Because it's not his forte.
That is the reason. That is the reason. And with that mind-blowing fact, I come to Jay to carry on.
Dude, I just want to blow everyone with this one thing. Like, I almost forgot about it, but this movie has the perfect release date. I will tell you why. 8 November 2019, right? The movie came. No, 18. Yeah. It was 18, right?
18, yeah. 18, yeah.
Just 2 years back, November 8, 2016. You know what happened? Demonetization happened.
Oh
yeah, see now see the pattern. We were getting robbed then, now they try to do the same thing with the theatrical experience. They're literally
thugs of Hindostan. It connects to me saying that Vijay Krishnachara is a raw agent. See,
yeah,
it
all see, connects exactly. I just can't believe, like, it's too good to be a coincidence, man. Yeah, okay, after getting that good, the thing about this movie is now, like, I want to talk about the pre-production which was happening. The buzz this movie was carrying around, like Amitabh Bachchan and Aamir Khan in one frame. After, like, haven't seen them like together, right?
Yeah, this was the first time.
The Yash Raj production. Okay, this big budget action adventure. Katrina Kaif is there for glamour. Fatima Sana Sheikh is there for acting. You got everything covered right there.
Come on, now Katrina Kaif is a pretty decent actor.
In that movie,
not in this, in this film, they don't do anything with her. Like in this film, now when she does the second dance performance, like as usual, like she has to do one more dance performance. After that, it's like they forgot about her. Like you don't see her at all. It's like, okay, Katrina, now get off stage. We have to continue the plot. I think the main problem with this film. It's not that, see, people tell the VFX is poor and everything. I'm like, I'm putting all that aside because the Indian industry, we're not quite there in terms of VFX. We're getting there. So we'll have movies where the VFX is not perfect and stuff like that. It's the fact that they couldn't sell me the story.
Yeah.
Like, I could not connect with any of the emotions. Like, when the, you know, whatever emotions were attached to that, the place, the kingdom which was captured by the British. Yeah. Or, you know, them coming back. Hmm. Like, I felt no emotions. So, even when Amitabh Bachchan was alive in the end, you know, towards the end, I was like, I don't really care. Like, you know, you're alive, you're dead. Like, you know, you can do anything here. Hmm. And I don't really care. Even this change of alliance.
Yeah.
Like, Amar Khan changes alliance so many times. I'm like, I don't know. I'm just watching it.
That's the thing now that now I'm coming to the technicality of the movie in the script. See, when your whole story revolves around one big twist now, it won't work out necessarily all the time because, see, you are not good at direction and storytelling part. Okay, he should be well aware of that. And we saw that.
Yeah, I think he's decent at direction. Like, he knows how to, like, get those, capture those shots and, like, beautiful frames.
Hmm.
But he struggles in capturing emotions.
Yeah.
It's so, like, I guess you can see he's one half good at one half good
at it's like, no, like, I have, like, for Thugs of Hindustan, you know, like, I have to like say in a line or something about this movie. It's a boring movie. This, like, I just could not bear, like, even I have seen Sahu and like, but it was kind of entertaining. It was trying to be entertaining. But with Thugs, I never, like, this is a huge 300 crore, like, biggest Bollywood, like, most expensive Bollywood movie ever. And it never felt to me like that. I don't know where he spent all that money. Maybe he kept it aside, like realizing that he fucked up everything. So let's better to keep the money inside.
See, No, I think he has great ambitions, and I really appreciate that he went out and he tried a movie like this, okay? And I can see that scale, you know, what he's trying to do with the shots and everything. And it's pretty good, you know. I admire his effort, and I would say, at least, you know, he's at least, you know, it's not like the prestige ripoff in Doom 3. Like, he's like trying to like build his own world here, you know, own characters and everything, but it's just not
now
there.
Now I got why this movie sucks. Because it's not a remake. My bad.
I mean, he didn't like. He still ripped off Pirates of Caribbean. Like, not rip off, but in terms of like, you know, Amar Khan's character seems very much similar to Johnny Depp's character. And like, see, they try to like convey these emotions that, you know, Amar Khan is like, you know, you have to be a changed person, and he gets inspired by, you know, Amitabh Bachchan's character. I'm like, how? Like, I don't see anything. Like, just couple of scenes, and you know, you had Amitabh Bachchan like blowing some land, and suddenly he's okay, you know, some person can't be changed, and okay, now I'm changed. Like, and.
Bro,
and don't get me started on the eagle that keeps coming everywhere. I want an eagle just for the, you know, my Wi-Fi connection. Like, I could like give my dong it could like fly up and just check, you know, where's the connection better, and it could like do that shrieking sound where the Wi-Fi is good. Like, I don't know, I'm just thinking in modern terms. But let's get to the British also speaking English.
Like, people, like, we need to realize that, dude, like, okay, for somewhat I can explain why, like, Britishers are talking to Indians in Hindi. With heavy heart, I will accept it.
I mean, that makes sense. No, that makes sense, because they were living in India. Huh. So they will have to pick up on the language.
Yeah.
Because if they want to talk to the Indian rulers and all, they'll have that. That is understandable.
But
yeah,
why the hell these guys are talking in Hindi with each other? Like, why? Like, look, I'm that bad Hindi. Like, you guys can speak English and the other guy can understand English as well. Like, why you're not talking in your mouth?
That too, very like difficult words. Like, you know, they're very complicated. Yeah. Like, it's like the Britishers are literally like saying poetry. Like, like literally poetry and stuff like that. And you know, when it got awkward, it got so awkward in the end, I think in the climatic battle, there's a scene between the British officers where they actually speak in English. Then once he's like, you know, I think they will surrender. And he's like, no, we're not going to take any prisoners. I'm like, why not Hindi then? Like, you were talking Hindi to each other, like, throughout the entire movie. Suddenly you're talking in English.
I just remembered one thing. Like, bro, like, I have, like, my whole school life has been a lie. My history teacher has lied to me. Our curriculum books have lied to us. Like, they have all proclaim like Britishers as this bad guy and wrong guy, but I just want to say they have a very kind heart. I mean, when Amir was making this excuse that her grandma died, the Britisher himself gave him extra money. Okay, go. I mean, bro, like, why are people painting Britishers as a bad guy? He's like, he that Britisher guy never met that Indian guy before, but just because hearing her grandma story, her gang story, they made, oh, poor chap, okay, give him the money and let him run away. I mean, what the heck?
It's like it's childish excuse. Like, he's supposed to be this very epic con man, and the excuse he uses is like, oh, my mother, my, you know, grandmother died. Like, I'm like, come on, like, seriously. Dude, one more thing I want to bring up, the fact is about Fatima Sana Sheikh. There's this romance they imply between Amar Khan and Fatima Sana Sheikh.
Creepy.
And I found it so weird, because I'm like,
creepy.
I feel like one movie back, you were playing her dad. Like, and now you're like trying to build this romance. It feels very weird.
Dude, it was very weird. I know, like, we shouldn't say that, because like with every movie that, but the way it was shown also, like, I couldn't, it was very, like, I couldn't.
It was an unnecessary
it, like,
one also, because there was nothing to build that chemistry anyways. And they were building it with Katrina Kaif's character, even though her time was very short-lived in the entire movie. I felt sad, because I'm like, she is absolutely beautiful and gorgeous, and she comes on screen, and then 5 minutes later, she's off, and the plot, they don't even explain why she's off, and again, in the end, she comes. Again, she's off. Like,
Dude, I just want to say the number of songs in the movie is positively related to Katrina Kaif's screen presence. The more number of songs, the more Katrina Kaif will appear. And the more Katrina Kaif will appear, the more number of songs. It's basically like both are related.
So it's a correlation. It's a correlation. Yeah. It's like price and supply. As price increases, the supply also increases. Like, they're bringing economics here. The good things of this film, I would say, are pretty good background music, even though it does borrow some inspiration from the Pirates of the Caribbean. It's still a pretty good background music. I thought, you know, it's pretty energetic. I also think the fight choreography in many of the shots are actually pretty decent, even though they do sort of adopt that, you know, quick cutting technique. But if you actually look at the fight, like some of the moves that Amar Khan does, or even Amitabh Bachchan's stunt double does, is actually pretty good. I know Amitabh Bachchan did many of the stunts on his own, but still, there had to be many stunts with the stunt double.
About that, I want to say that, like, see, you are in your 70s, okay? You're not supposed to show your dedication here. When we are, you are portraying a character of a warrior, okay, who can fight and do whatever he want. Let a stunt double do that and make us believe more. Because by seeing Amitabh Bachchan and those lazy ass movements he does, I know his age doesn't support him. And we are not even expecting that from him. That's where the stunt double comes in. You don't have to show your dedication that, oh, so Mr. Bachchan is showing his like dedication in his 70s. Bro,
there were definitely instances where you were like, he's too old for this.
Yeah.
Like, they definitely overestimated his...
I admire
his capability to do it. Like, I admire that a lot. But I'm like, this is not the movie for him to actually go on to do this. I was a little disappointed. But I still think like the actual moves, like some of the choreography, I was like, especially when on the rewatch, when I was watching, I'm like, they actually put some detail into this, like, you know, that fight over there, that move over there and stuff like that. Although some of them were total nonsense, like there were definitely some nonsense stuff happening in the middle of it. But see, overall, I think this film, what do you think, Jay? Is it so bad that it's good?
No, it's so bad. It's, you know what, like, it's more of a disappointing affair than a bad movie for me, because like I was expecting, so even like even for the least, you know, I was expecting some good memorable scene. I still don't know, the first time I saw this movie in theater with my whole family, I don't know why I did that. Maybe because like the whole family was going to see something.
It was Diwali, right? So
yeah, basically we all went there and like I pretty much read all the every review which came now were all negative. So that moment I was like, okay, so I was not expecting anything from the movie. But when I watched it now, I was like, it's a bland movie. It's like nothing bad.
That is his Vijay Krishna Acharya straight. True. Like, I've not watched all of his films, so I can't comment. Like, I've not watched Tashan and all. But from what I've watched of his work, it's pretty much like big ideas but bland way of presenting. Like, there's a shot in the starting where I think Amitabh Bachchan's character, like, he comes on the horseback and there is smoke everywhere. Like, orange color smoke comes behind him and it looks fantastic. And, you know, I admire his vision of going for this big kind of, you know, appeal, big kind of movie. And, you know, it's that movie cinematic experience that he's going for. But the problem is that the story is... See, and in movies like this, the story is never the strongest part. Like, if you watch any of the Pirates of the Caribbean movie, it's not that the story is, like, that mind-blowing story. It's like, it's a pretty entertaining story those movies have. And this, the story is just not that entertaining. Like, it doesn't sell us on any of the emotions. Like, I don't feel any of the emotions. And the characters are bland. That's the biggest problem. Like, I don't find any of these characters very memorable. But it's the same twist again and again. It won't work because the audience sees right through it. You're like, how many times can a guy, you know, betray someone else? Like, I'm like, you know, the only one you're betraying is the audience.
But by the time I first watched Amir Khan's character, forget even the movie. When I first saw the motion poster of Amir Khan, I guessed that, okay, so in the trailer it was shown that he's going to betray or he's going to be this con man. But I knew that at the end he will support Indians. That's like,
That's because they casted Amar Khan. If you cast Amar Khan, there's no other way the film is going to go. Like, if it was someone else, if they had casted someone who normally plays a villain role in this,
true.
then it would have actually worked. But it's pretty boring. It's probably not how you want to spend your Diwali.
No,
Don't
definitely
watch this
not.
film on Diwali is what I would say.
You know, at the end, I just want to say one thing. Like, we still, like, as Bollywood, we still haven't got the right action adventure movie. I think people here doesn't realize what the true meaning of action adventure, because like this movie was definitely far away from adventure as it could have been. See,
No, it
and
was an
this
adventure to get through it, no.
yeah, that's it. But that's not what their intent was while making the movie. That's why I'm really looking forward to Brahmastra, Ayan Mukherjee, Ranbir Kapoor trilogy. This like fantasy adventure movie, because like it's
See, but you're doing a safe bet, Jay. I am excited for Vijay Krishna Acharya's next film. I want to see which character dies in the first 10 minutes, which character will go undercover. These are
true.
the things that I am excited for. Like, I am a true fan of Vijay Krishna Acharya. You have a true fan here.
And one fun fact, I don't know how many of you guys know that, but Vijay Krishna Acharya is famously called Victor Nolan.
I think he has earned that
Yeah,
name.
he's pretty much earned
Honestly, like, he has earned that name.
that.
Like, you know, like, this film is because, you know, like they say now, this great minds make great movies.
True.
This film is above our level. That's why I keep telling you, man. It's
They
actually
are not
brilliant.
quite there
And
yet, yeah.
yeah, that's true. Like, and none of the critics were also there yet, and the audience were also not there yet.
Yeah.
But
Nobody.
on that note, but like, and we will end by saying this: don't watch this movie again on Diwali. It is available on Prime Video, but don't watch it. Watch it
Never
again.
watched
There's lots
this
of good
movie.
stuff in Prime.
Yeah.
There's lots of good stuff. I mean, you can watch it for how beautiful Katrina Kaif looks, but you can also watch that in YouTube. So
Yeah.
you can pick your choices. You can pick your choices there. But watch something else. But I would still say this film is better than Happy New Year. So there is that.
What? That's a very
This is
weird.
the
That's a very weird
because
thing to bring right now.
Happy New Year was also a Diwali release, right?
Many movies are Diwali
Happy New
release.
Year was also a Diwali.
There is Prem Rathan Dhan Payo. There is Happy New Year. There is this.
I'm
There.
thinking, which is the one Diwali movie that people can rewatch?
Shit, Diwali has been cursed, man.
I think all the
Wait,
films
wait,
that
wait,
come
wait.
up.
Nahi, Secret Superstar came in Diwali.
Okay, so enjoy your Diwali by rewatching Secret Superstar, which is a much better Amar Khan film.
Much better, much, much better.
Much better. Like, see, anyway, you can't go out. It's COVID-19, so, you know, maybe sit inside and watch Secret Superstar, which maybe is available on Prime Video or Netflix or Hotstar.
Yeah.
Somewhere it's probably there.
Now
On that
that's an
note,
action adventure you have to look for where it is available.
yes. So get the action. Take on the adventure, find where Secret Superstar is, leave it in the comment section below, save us some trouble, and you know, celebrate your Diwali by watching Secret Superstar again. Stay safe, guys, and you know, wishing you guys a happy Diwali. This video will probably like release around that time. Few days before that, let's say.
You know what, Monday, possible, can you add that popular iconic Diwali song? मेरी तुम्हारी सबके लिए हैप्पी दिवाली.
See, I would, but copyright issues, and now you sang it, so people have that already. So why would we need to add it? Like, can we maybe get that guy who did that? You know, he puts auto tune and makes the beats and all. We can put that into your singing.
We'll see there.
But anyway guys, have a great Diwali. We were just talking about this film. It was not like easy watch. I mean, I think. We understood what the movie was going for. We're not trying to be overly negative, but this film didn't really work for us, and it didn't work for a lot of people, and it's not really fun to revisit also. On that note, and looking forward to the next Vikram Acharya movie, we come to the end of this video. Do have a great weekend.